Det gjør stid for.
Hello, art family, and thanks for all the new subscribers. By request on Instagram, I decided to do a little video on how I adapted a Classic-2 Artwork Essentials EASyl, which is an oil painting pochéd box, into a watercolor EASyl, similar to the type that Joseph Spukvik carries. This is the Classic-2 EASyl that they offer. It's 14 by 18, so it's very large. It's made of a really good hardwood. I'm really impressed with the materials that they use. It normally comes with a spring-loaded area to hold oil painting panels, but I asked to have it without that stuff in it, and they were kind enough to send me basically the case of the box without it. I had to replace one area, which I'll talk about in a minute. I was really impressed with the knobs that hold it open. I actually emailed them because I got cold feet about it, wondering if it was going to be strong enough to stay open. And they assured me it would, and sure enough, it's extremely strong, the knobs. You get two of them, and they hold it open at any angle. As for modification, I was going to remove this interior stuff, but ended up making more of a mess, and I was afraid of damaging it, so I just chiseled it down flat so it was flush. I then added this lip to work on, essentially turning it into a portable drafting table. The lip is just two dowels. It's a square dowel and a flat dowel that I think is a half inch for the square dowel, and then a 3/4 inch flat dowel, just regular wood. I took a little bit of honey stain and lightly stained it, and I added some D-rings and that little brass clip I took off an old broken down French EASyl. I wasn't sure what stain their color was, so I just used a little bit of honey and very quickly wiped it off, and it matched pretty close. I then sprayed the whole top with a polyurethane spray. On the top, where the old oil painting piece was that slipped in and out, I had to replace that with another piece of wood that I cut to that size right there, which was a simple fix. I was able to wood glue that to the piece that would hold the oil painting stuff, but I left that stuff in just to give some support to the lid. I was going to sand and stain the whole interior, but I figured you're never going to see that side, so I gave up on doing that part. So it's a little marred on the inside, but the inside holds my paint box, and that's an 11.5 by 16.5 watercolor paper. It comes with this really heavy, nice, quick release clip that you can add a tripod to it, so I can fasten it to my tripod pretty quickly. And then it opens at any angle and I can lock it in place. On the inside, I used some more of those dowels and a flat piece of plywood to make this little shelf, organizing shelf that's removable. And then the company themselves sell a couple cool pieces I got as well, like this little brass hook you can hang a water cup off. They also sell this big, or I guess it's stainless steel brush holder. I think the hook's probably stainless steel too. The interior of the box is big enough that I can fit my watercolor box if I want to. And then they make this palette extension, which works as a good shelf. Initially, I was going to cut the whole side out and make a slide out shelf, but I felt like it might be a little bit rickety that way, and I wanted to see if this was solid, and it turned out to be very, very solid and hold on very tightly and snugly, and so I'm not that worried about adding anything else to it. I think that cantilever shelf is going to be strong enough for what I do. So here's a look at the full setup, and then I'll show you taking it out for the first time. The size, 14 by 18, is big enough to hold most watercolor sheets that you would buy in a pad. Most of the time I work 9 by 12 anyways, which is what I'm doing right here. I actually use the side knob to hold my water cup, which is a travel cup that I drilled two holes in and put a leather string through so that it can hang off the front, or I can just set it on the little cantilever shelf. The wood is very hard and it's nice, although it's still very lightweight, so I feel like it'll travel really easily. It is heavy after I put all my stuff in it. Some other further modifications I've done is I cut some corrugated board so that I can make a sunscreen on the top, and also I covered the inside so I can slip paper on the interior so I can carry just single sheets instead of full pads. And there's a look at the sunscreen with some little clips that I use so that I can also have some shade. That's it for this little video on modifying the Classic 2 from Artwork Essentials. I hope you got a lot out of it, and I'd love to see the kind of modifications and ideas that you've come up with. Thanks for watching, and in the meantime, I'll see you in the next video. Happy sketching.